Hey there, everybody. Mountain Grandma here. My name is Tammy, and thank you for coming to my channel. Today, I am participating in a challenge that I heard about from Yogi Hollow Farms, and the challenge was actually initiated by Ormsby Farms. I will put the links to both of those channels in the description below. So this challenge was a $10 dinner challenge on making a meal for less than $10. And I just happened to kind of stumble across this little idea the other day because I forgot to take meat out of the freezer. So we had bought at the grocery store, we usually like to stock up on meats and meat type cans of foods, you know, just as a prepping thing, really. And they're nice to have in case you forget to take meat out of the freezer. Normally we buy corned beef hash, but I wasn't paying real close attention when we were at the grocery store. And I ended up buying this roast beef hash, which I never tried. And I had I have multiple cans of this, and I was wondering what to do with it. When I first bought it, I was like, oh shoot, I got the wrong dadgum thing. So now I gotta figure out what to do with it. So the opportunity became available. My husband was craving, of all things, he wanted mac and cheese. Like the cheap mac and cheese from a box, which usually if we have it, you know, we'll make it homemade or something. So he wanted this one though. And so I was looking for a counterpart to go with that, and I didn't have any deer meat or ground beef thawed out. So I went ahead and pulled this can out, and lo and behold, it made a wonderful meal, enough so that he's asking for it again today. So since this happened, I thought I would share with you all. And this is for us, for the two of us, this is, you know, less than $5. I think this cost me like $2 at Walmart. And of course this, like back in the day, they used to be three for a dollar. Now they're like a dollar a piece, but so $3, even for a larger family, you could have two cans and two boxes of mac and cheese, and you're still well below, then you're at like what, $6? Well below $10 for the family. So I've got water boiling to make the mac and cheese. I've got my skillet out for the roast beef hash. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cook the mac and cheese, cook the roast beef hash, and then I mix them all together. And it actually turns out really good. So I'm gonna get going on this, and then I will share with you all once it's done. Hey, so I forgot about the half a stick of butter and the quarter cup of milk. In my case, I'm using cream, but I will add that into my final total at the end. And we're just about ready to mix these together. Just a note too, when I first made this, I actually served mac and cheese, roast beef hash, and some vegetables. That was my husband's plate of food. Well, we had leftovers, so two people, you're gonna have leftovers. This is a lot for just two people. And so we had leftovers, and when I heated them up in the skillet, because we don't use a microwave, when I heated them up in the skillet, they kind of mixed together just a little bit, but when I put it on my husband's plate, he started mixing it all up because he said it tasted really good together. So you could serve it separately, or you could mix it all up together. Mixed up together, it is really good. And I'm just about ready to get this all mixed up, so I'll be back with you in just a minute. There we go. You could add in a can of tomatoes, onions, whatever you all want, but quick and easy, just like this, tastes good. And I'll have the total for you and what it costs to make the whole plate.